This Lamb County Leader News Friday Night Football Spotlight is sponsored by Sudan Independent School District. Sudan Schools, where the choice for greatness is yours. Exemplary academics, athletics, fine arts, and career in technology. Sudan ISD are proud supporters of Sudan Hornets and Nets athletics. Good luck to the Hornet football team on Friday, and go get them, Hornets! Friday Night Football Spotlight is sponsored by Texas Producers Co-op, your one-stop co-op for cotton gin, farm store, auto services, fuel, chemical, and barbershop. Good luck on Friday, Hornets.
I'm joined here by Sudan senior wide receiver Michael Lamone. Michael, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, man. Hey, I understand you didn't play last week. Just what are you most looking forward to about getting out on the field this week against Farwell?
Just to get out there and play, put some points on the board, and help my teammates to win a game this season. So.
Okay. And, you know, you guys, 0-2 this far, but, you know, you played some tough Division I competition. How do you feel your week of preparation has gone this far this week?
I think it's been going great. You know, last week we had a bunch of turnovers against Sundown and just mental mistakes that we need to fix. And I feel like this week we've been doing great and we've been trying to fix. The coach has been doing a great job helping us trying to fix it.
Okay. And then just lastly here, what do you feel will be some keys to getting a victory against Farwell on Friday?
No turnovers. We don't need those turnovers. We need points.
All right.
And our defense has been doing great these past 2 games, so I think we need to keep that up. Here's another one.
This Friday Night Football Spotlight is sponsored by Sawyer Construction, proud supporters of Sudan Athletics. Contact 806-523-1627 for all of your new home construction or remodeling needs. Honesty you can count on. Go get them, Hornets.
I'm joined here by Sudan senior offensive lineman Gabriel Cisneros. Gabriel, how you doing?
Good. You?
Doing good. Hey, man, you guys had a tough loss against Sundown last week. Just what do you feel you guys have to do to get back on track heading into Farwell this week?
Well, we got to really work on holding that ball. Not so many turnovers and get better in offense, and then we should be right on track.
Okay. And, you know, this is a rivalry game. You know, it doesn't matter how both teams are doing. Whenever you put Sudan and Farwell on the same field, it's going to be a slugfest. So just what are you most looking forward to about the matchup this week?
I just hope we do real good offense and defense-wise. And that's all I want. And I hope it's a dogfight.
All right. I appreciate your time, bud.
This Friday Night Football Spotlight is sponsored by Lands Insurance of Sudan, serving Texas since 1972. We are proud supporters of Sudan Athletics, with 2 locations to serve you in Sudan and Littlefield. Go get them, Hornets.
Derek Lopez here from the Lamb County Leader News in our Friday Night Football Spotlight this week. Takes us out to Sudan with the Hornets and head coach John Cornelius. Coach, how you doing?
Doing well.
Coach, you guys had a tough loss last Friday against Sundown. Give me your takeaways from that contest as you guys prepare to go on the road for the first time this season.
Well, you know, first off, I thought that the effort and The intensity was good all night. Our kids played really good on defense. We only gave up 200 yards of offense to Sundown. But the seven turnovers is what really did us in. We got to do a better job of holding on to the football and taking care of that ball when we're on offense.
Okay. And, you know, defensively last week you guys forced a couple turnovers. Just what do you feel you guys need to do to keep Farwell in check this week, and who will be some key guys to keep an eye on?
Well, you know, Farwell's a good, balanced football team. They run the ball and throw it well. I think, you know, it starts with their running back, the Stancil kid. He's a dangerous weapon back there. Then, you know, they got the big receiver, the Henderson kid, on the outside that if you don't take care of business, he'll hurt you out there as well. So I just think we got to be disciplined on defense. Right now we've been playing good defense. We did a good job against Sundown of not giving up the big play, so that was an improvement. But, just continue doing what we're doing defensively.
Okay. And offensively, what do you guys have to do to be successful this week in order to get that offense going?
Well, you know, first off is the turnovers. You know, first week we gave up 2 pick sixes and 7 turnovers last week. You know, that's been the story for us, is just not holding on to the football. And then not only that, it's been setting them up inside the 10, you know, for a very short field for them to score. So we've been putting our defense in a bad position. So take care of the ball and then just execute. You know, we're either getting penalties or we're turning it over. We gotta eliminate those two things.
Okay. And lastly here, Coach, just what do you feel will be some key matchups on Friday?
You know, I think, again, you know, we talked a little bit about the Stancil kid at running back and then the Henderson kid on the outside. I think we got to do a good job of limiting those two guys. And then, you know, for us offensively, you know, our O-line versus their D-front, you know, we're going to have to try to, you know, create some gaps and some lanes for our running backs and get the ground game going.
Okay. Again, appreciate your time, Coach. And the Hornets will be on the road on Friday at 7 o'clock at Farwell to take on the Steers.
This is Kevin Campbell at John Rowley's Auto Center right here in Littlefield. If you're looking for a new Chevrolet car, truck, or SUV, come out and see us today. And we want to wish the best of luck to all of our area football teams this season.